Everyone, welcome to ION Entertainment on Amazon Prime. We're at the Wind International Film Festival, and this is the eighth year, and we're so excited and honored to be with the CEO and founder of the Wind International Film Festival, Dr. Elham Madani.
I'm so excited to have you again. thank you for accepting our invitation and come to the Wind International Film Festival. And today we have beautiful films. It's so exciting. The quality of the films get better and better. And people flying from different parts of the world to come and join our festival. We have from Germany today. We have from France. We have from India, Malaysia, Taiwan, and Belgium, Switzerland, Bulgaria, and this is the films we are showing today, and we are now in the two branches. So some of our films are being screened here, and then some of the other films are going to be screening there. And we are getting bigger and bigger because we have you filmmakers, and we are proud of your films. And I'm speechless. I'm so happy.
Well, I know you're busy. I mean, Elham's in charge of everything today, and everyone's arriving.
No, but not only the person. We have a lot of great people.
Yeah.
But because I'm the founder, people looking at me like a mother for them. So I'm in charge of taking care of my babies.
Yeah, and there's so many important people here. But tell us a little bit about your film, ISIS Crisis.
Oh, ISIS Crisis is a feature documentary that it took us about 3 years to shoot and collect the data because it's real. And it won in many film festivals if you're comparing the importance of this in the festivals. And it's focusing on the empowerment of the ladies and how young ladies, young women, and especially kids, teenagers, young girls, are fighting for their country. You know, they're focusing not about only makeup, the things that is based on our, you know, we are women, and but they're focusing more about to bring freedom to the to be free out of the, how can I say, not to be under the harassment of the soldiers that they want to rape them. So they rather to fight, not to be raped. That is so important. They're fighting for their freedom, you know, their inner things. Yeah.
And that's why the Wind International Film Festival is so important, because Dr. Madani wants to empower women, but also wants to empower the humanity of the, especially Middle Eastern countries that are...
Especially Middle Eastern countries, we can say yes, because now there is a lot of war in those countries because they are wealthy.
Yeah.
So everybody wants to take something out of them, mostly, and they are under kind of like a misconception, you know. So we want to bring the untold stories. And make this untold stories into the film and tell about who they are and showing the beautiful of America to them as well. Because now we are hosting many filmmakers from overseas, right?
Uh-huh.
So we are beautiful living here, and they are beautiful to join us. So we want to connect together. And the name of the Wind is because the wind is like a wind of freedom, wind of joyness, wind of empowerment. It's like a breeze. It's a bridge. So the wind comes from that, but W is standing for women, but it's not about women. W, the first letter is women. But I is standing for innovation, and N, United Nations, the product is going to be more about humanitarianism and the good works that we can save the world, we can save the life, and D is about diversity. So it's about everyone, but we want to create some works and some films that has a meaning. And changing the world to the better road, you know, that kind of thing. This is our vision. It's so important. And we expect that people are understanding about that and join and make greater films. We love all the films because we are filmmakers, right? So, but yeah, kind of.
Well, thank you so much. I know you're busy. Thank you for joining us. And Akia Leong and I will be co-hosting the award show on Sunday. So we'll do another interview with Dr. Elham.
One more interview because the filmmakers want to have interview with you on your channel.
And also, her show is on our ION Entertainment on Amazon Prime channel. So please check it out on Amazon Prime.
Sure. I can say to my fans, they love you and they're going to follow your works, and we are all connected.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Well, we're so excited to have the great filmmaker and martial artist J.J. Stomp with us. His film, John Kincaid Unleashed, is being shown here at the festival, and we've introduced you to the CEO and founder of the festival, Dr. Elham Madani. Okay, well, hi, J.J.
So, how are you? You look fabulous today. You look beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
You look so beautiful today.
Thank you.
Got
you.
This is amazing.
So tell us about your film.
Well, where do I want to start it? So the film is really phenomenal. We are releasing 60 countries at this time and doing pretty well. Thank you. And the most important is, I'm so amazing this screening here at Wynn International Film
Festival.
It's amazing.
This is the beauty of the festival because we are collecting the best and from diversity background, and this gentleman is amazing. His film, I mean, all of the films, I have to be fair because it's like all of them are like my children. I can say the films are like our product because we love them. To be a judge is very hard, but each film has a beautiful point. Beautiful thing. You really, to be judged is really, really hard. My judges, like, we have this time, I think that's 17 judges, and the scoring of this film, his film, is that much hard. We had to go negotiate, oh no, that film, oh no, 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 it's very hard, because the films are great.
What is your film nominated for?
Wow, best action film? And best actors and best directors.
Oh my goodness. Well, I've seen the film. I went to the premiere in Los Angeles. It's a fantastic film, but you have every martial artist in the world in it, it seems.
Yes.
And you're the best.
Well, thank you for that. But, you know, we did have a lot of martial arts involved. But just say, this is an amazing event, okay? Because I watched a few films. They're so amazing. And she's right. It's really hard to decide which one is the one. But all I can say is a wish to all the filmmakers the best. You know, it doesn't matter which way we go. We're here. Okay?
Yes,
we celebrate it.
We see that filmmakers, because they are not competing each other when they see. So many of them came and they say, wow, they love this film. And this is like a great networking. You are going to be a part of the other project. That is our concern, to get you and put you in another project. So one time you are director of your film, another day you might be a co-producer of the other film or the actor of the other film, you know?
Yes.
So it's a networking. Festival is about to find the right people on the right spot instead of wasting your time going like 1,000 times to an event. You can't find the right people. Here it is, the hero of the action movies.
Well,
and good,
he's a
good
actor in action, and everybody, I believe that they love him. He's so fun. I call him Jackie Chan.
Thank you.
Well,
Jackie, okay, it's all right. But anyway, I want to say thank you. You know what? Since I've been here, I had a lot of connections. People are talking to me about in their film or come to my film, and I'm happy.
Yeah.
And I'm very happy. This is amazing.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Thank you to have you.
Well, can we talk just really quickly about all of the other films you're filming right now?
Yes,
you know, you've been jetting. You've been jetting across the country. I can't keep up with you.
Yes, I'm flying everywhere. Like this week, I'm gonna go to Texas, then Vegas, and Arizona. I'm filming 5 films at this point. It all action martial arts. I have one stunt kid. I have a good person in it. Gloria Hendry is part of it. It's an amazing person. And also we have Ace in the Session. I have a beautiful person, beautiful ladies in it, that's just next to me,
wow,
right here. Yeah. I want to welcome, and we also have Entry Dragon, great martial artist from Hawaii. Michelle Manu is going to be part of that film. Very powerful, okay? And boy, yeah, you name all these movies, it just
busy. Coming. The other just one, busy. Another one.
Yeah, yes. So lots of films for next year.
Yeah, we're going to have a lot of films then from one director.
And I know you want to be part of my film, right?
Sure.
Yeah. So.
Yes, and also I've told JJ like 4 times now, but Dr. Elham Madani is a martial artist also.
Wow. Now they're going to see
you. I'm a white belt.
Yeah, right. It's okay. You can move up.
Okay. No, I'll learn from the best.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, and thank you, everybody.
Thank you for being a part of the beautiful home that is called Wind International Film Festival.
Yes.
And we'll see you at the award show with Akia Leung.
Of course, sure. I will. Can't miss that, right?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, we're so lucky to be with actor and filmmaker and martial artist Robert Parham, and filmmaker, director, and actor,
writer,
everything.
Yeah,
why Elaine D'Souza. So they're both here for Jackson Bolt. Now, tell me about the film.
Basically, Jackson Bolt was a story of a cop with some marriage problems trying to clear his name in the murder of his partner. And there's a lot of other issues and subplots that are addressed in the film, but that's the main focus of the movie.
Okay. And how did the film get started?
It got started because my good friend and buddy over here called me 5 times and convinced me to direct the film. So I finally said yes.
Okay. Well, how did you two meet?
Oh, wow. We met at
9 years ago.
About 9 years ago at a, and I just moved to California. And I was looking for some acting classes, and this gentleman had advertised some acting classes, so I went to his acting class and been tight ever since.
Okay, so you're from San Francisco.
I live in this area, but I actually grew up on the East Coast.
Oh.
So I now live in the Bay Area, but I was down here for 7 years. But I left Microsoft to come back to do what I have my first love, which is art.
You worked for Microsoft?
Yeah, I was IT for 20... I don't want to give my age out too much, a long time.
Oh my gosh, I used to be in software.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, we have a lot in common.
Yeah.
Okay, well, tell our audience about your martial arts history, because it's amazing.
Well, basically, I really got started when I got beat up in the 5th grade by this girl. And my dad kept me in all summer long to, you know, do martial arts. And when I was in the military, I met my primary martial arts instructor, Dr. Jones, and we went on and I won some national titles, state titles, regional titles in what they call semi-contact karate. And then I turned to kickboxing, where I eventually won 5 world titles in 5 different weight divisions.
Yeah, isn't that amazing? Okay, now what did you do in the Army?
Actually, it was the Air Force.
Oh, okay, I love the Air Force. My dad was in the Air Force.
There you go, yeah. So I was an LVN in the Air Force.
Okay.
So, you know, it's funny because I do the films and all the martial arts and I, like, take people apart, but I really have a big heart and I put people together, so, you know.
Okay, and then you worked for Microsoft, so how did you get started teaching acting then?
Well, actually, see, that was a middle career. I started when I was 13. I had my freshman English teacher in high school. I was very shy, and he forced me to try out for a school play. I told him, no, I'm just going to play football and get my A's. He said, I'll flunk you. So I showed up for tryouts, and I took a liking to it. And from that point on, almost all through high school and college, I played all the different roles, did theater till I was 28, and it's in film. And my very first film I did was called Yesterday, for a graduate project in high school, because we had to do projects. And it got best film. So I've been addicted, and was on film. We had to cut it with razor blades. No computers.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, so are you an editor, too?
We do editing. Robert does editing. We kind of like to control the product, because editing is where you really make the movie.
Yeah.
What we like to say is when we're on set, we're not making a movie. The cameras are the brushes. The actors are the paint. And I'm mixing a palette. Then you take that palette with as much color as you can, and you bring it into the editing room, and now you make your movie. Because all the other artists are contributing. You had a script, and the director takes that script and does all kinds of things to it. But then the actors come in with all this different emotions and all these layers of things. So we just mix this beautiful palette and editing, you make your film. And some of the best, my mentor in film, Akira Kurosawa, he edited all his films. So there's a little hint there. If you really want to control your creative product, you should edit your films.
Okay. Well, I knew that you were a great director because I saw Jackson Bold. But you're also an actor. You can see his demo reel on my Facebook page.
It's on your page? Thank you so much.
Yeah, it's wonderful. And so what projects are you working on now?
Right now, we are in the midst of a sequel to Jackson Bold. Fred Williamson was here earlier, and so he's agreed to it. We're doing a movie right now called Soul Cage with my partner in my production company, Jim Meyer. And we have about 18 or 19 other scripts and projects on a slate that we're going to be doing in the next 2 or 3 years.
So there's never a dull moment with you.
Never a dull moment.
Do you sleep?
I try sometimes, you know, so for what it's worth.
What projects do you have?
We're collaborating projects, but we have another project out right now. The short version is called Blood Freedom. Uh-huh. It's a historical fiction, but it combines things that happened at the end of the Civil War and what's going on today. And that actually just hit the festival circuit. The first acceptance, it was a semi-finalist. But we're doing the feature version of that now, too. And then after that, I have just written a script called Tragic Triumph, which is another historical fiction that I hope to somehow fit in between our other projects.
Okay. Well, out of all the things you do, what do you like best?
This is a question I get asked a lot, and I can't say that because I think, like life, everything is holistic. It's like saying, do I like my mind, my body, or my spirit? They have to work together in this synchronicity, and I feel the same way about the art of film. Okay. You know, I could never see myself just starting a film and not being involved in the holistic process of it, you know?
Well, that's why your films are great, then.
Okay. Well, thank you. We hope so.
What do you like best?
Well, definitely action. I'm not like Ali. Definitely action, you know? Let's shoot somebody, let's kick somebody in the head, let's blow something up, and have a great time doing it. So definitely that's what I'm all about.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for this interview, and we'll see you at the award show.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Don.
Hello. We're so excited to have the great actor and filmmaker Iyad Hajjaj with us. So, welcome.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really thrilled to be here.
Well, you know, let's get straight to your great film. Tell us about it.
Well, thank you so much. I'm a strong believer on ending the human trafficking and child abuse issue that has been bothering the whole world. And I took on this one story, and I wanted to tell the world about how this little girl was taken from her family home, brought to another country, and what she had to go through in order to please this other family. A lot of abuse, a lot of sexual harassment, a lot of bad treatment, no school, deprivation of a lot of things. So I just wanted to show the world a small glimpse of what could be happening to a lot of other children in the world. So hopefully I did that.
Is this a true story?
It is based on true events, yes.
Gosh, it sounds exactly like what Ilham fights for.
Yes.
How did you hear about the festival?
Well, it was through friends, and they told me about Wind International Film Festival, and they told me they do support and sponsor the cause of human trafficking, and I believe that was a great match for us to be working on the same topic.
Okay. Yeah, this year I'm so happy that we got the most amazing films that is about humanitarianism. They are starting to know it, what is our vision, because it's not only about the festival to show the films, it's about choosing the right films for the world, to make the world, to change, to make a great effect, impact to the world. And his film was a great option for this festival, and because we are fighting for human abuse, abuse, and so we are fighting for animal abuse, and his film is great, and he did a great job by choosing the right people and really paying attention to detail, like my other filmmakers also. So as I mentioned, that to be as a judge, to finally to mention who is going to be the finally in categories is extremely hard, especially this year. This season is really, really hard.
Well, I don't know if you could see the poster, but the stars in this film are Malcolm McDowell, Robin Givens, and Iyad. So how did you get these stars?
Well, I started a film that can be just a small independent film that will tell the story. And God just blessed me with how many people jumped in and wanted to support the cause as well, including my stars. Malcolm McDowell was a little, okay, who is this guy I want to work with? But when he read the story, he called me. He said, Iyad, is this based on a true story? I said, yes. He said, I thought so. I want to do it. And then he did it. I was thrilled. I was really happy that a caliber of Malcolm McDowell and Robin Givens wanted to work on my film, because we all wanted to tell that story.
Well, it's amazing. I mean, I just can't wait to see the film myself, and congratulations.
Thank you so much for being here, and I'd love for you to see the film and enjoy the story.
Okay, so thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, we're here with Zachary, and can you tell us about your film coming out?
Okay, so the film is called Father Figures. It's a Warner Brothers feature film. It has Ed Helms, Owen Wilson, J.K. Simmons, Glenn Close, Cat Williams in it. I play Ed Helms' son, and basically what the movie is about is that it's Ed Helms and Owen Wilson, who are brothers, who have thought their father has been dead this whole time, realize that their father is actually alive. So they go on this epic quest to find their father, and then I'm Ed Helms' son. So it's like he's also trying to get a better relationship with me.
Oh. Okay, well, tell us about your career.
Okay, well, I've been acting for about 7 years, I would say. I moved here to Georgia when I was about 7 as well. And the first thing I did when I came out here was Criminal Minds. And it was an awesome episode. I got to work with amazing people, and it was just really fun to do it. I've loved
acting. I love Criminal Minds. Which episode was it?
I forgot. It was such a long time ago.
How old were you?
I was very young. I was like 6 or 7.
Okay. Oh, my goodness. Did you always know you wanted to act?
Yes and no. I did a talent show type thing where the judges were agencies. Uh-huh. And after I did my my monologue, they said that I was actually a really good actor, and I was kind of interested in that, so I went to go do some classes, see if I wanted to pursue it, and I did, so we moved out here.
Okay, well, how did you hear about our festival?
Well, my publicist, Desiree, actually got me in, and I know this is with DACA and everything, and I don't know much about it, but I'm hoping after learning about it that I can know a little bit more about it.
Oh, that's great. I can't wait to see your film. I mean, you've got major stars in there. Congratulations. Yeah. How old are you?
I'm 13.
Okay, well, actually, that's really young. I thought maybe you were, you know, 17 or something. you're so well-spoken.
Thank you.
I can't wait to see your film. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
We're here with Joyce Chow, and everybody, she's the most popular person here. So tell us about your career.
Oh, my God. Wait, we got it. Okay. Well, here's the funny part is, okay, so we were on set together for Vapors, and it's like, you have the wildest outfit.
I know.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, vape wars, vaping wars, okay, you kind of have an idea about it. Wait a minute, did you blow smoke?
I was in the vape part of it.
We were in a contest to vape and blow smoke. Anyway,
well, actually, I got to dance. So,
and it was so much fun because, first of all, not only were we in Los Angeles, in the heart of Los Angeles,
in Skid Row. In the middle. I've never seen those tents before.
We were very happy to be inside.
Okay. Yes.
And, of course, in the movie, directed by Christy Oldham and Clinton Wallace, we also had Ron Jeremy.
Yes, and I got to dance with him.
Did you see him play the harmonica?
Yes.
Yes, and he played the organ.
Oh, no, I didn't.
You didn't see him? Oh, yeah, she's like, okay. Ron Jeremy playing the harp. Yes. And the dude. Now, the dude as in the real dude, not Jeff Bridges who plays the dude. Jeff Dowd.
Oh.
What? Okay. Yes, he was there.
Oh, my gosh.
I know. So anyway, we were so much fun. And Vapors is now on Amazon, which is the really fun part. And then we're getting ready for the holidays because, you know, Halloween's right around the corner. So this year our Christmas show is called Christmas is Love. And it's going
to the Wing International Film Festival.
Yes! Oh, we should do that.
Yes!
So it's all about, of course, Christmas and music, people bringing Christmas to kids.
We have a family section, too.
It's all family.
It's family section.
Oh, you do? Okay, we will do that. Best family. Okay. So we have all day to bring Christmas to kids. Last year what we did Christmas is Joy, and we had all of these kids there. We gave them a Christmas. We brought them presents and toys and entertainment, and yes, we want to do that again for them, too. But this year in L.A., in the Grove, with the Salvation Army. Yes. So it'll be awesome. So that's a Thursday after Thanksgiving, and we're kicking off their celebrity, their kettle kickoff. In fact, it kicks off the holiday season for the Salvation Army. And the kettle is, you know those, the little, they ring the bell?
Yes,
those kettles, yes.
So Joyce, what is your company?
Let's see.
How many companies do you have?
I've got like 7 websites. Just follow me all over social media as at Monty Bubbles, MONTEBUBBLES. But you can see what Monty Bubbles Entertainment is, MBN News Video Web. We're working on a number of projects, but this is one thing I will tell you. There's a lot in the works, whether it's film, television, or, well, you never know what we're up to.
Thank you.
You could be vaping.
I have to go.
You can go.
Sorry.
Yes.
My filmmakers are waiting. I have to go.
Okay. But you're going to come.
Yeah. Just right now from the video, I'm just
saying. Okay. Okay.